Hey guys, how are you? It's CP Jason, Greenville Academy Martial Arts. Thank you so much for watching. And as always, we're trying to help you become better self-defenders. And in this case, we're going over the big myths of Bruce Lee because there's just a lot of myths out there that aren't going to help anybody. So if you're not sure what to believe about Bruce Lee, here are some of the big top myths that we've seen. Number one, jumping right into this, number one is Bruce Lee did not master the Wing Chun system. When he was in Hong Kong, he didn't start until he was in his mid-teens. And he left when he was 18. And, you know, he was kind of busy. He was a child actor. He was going to school. He was a Hong Kong dancing champion. And plus, he was doing martial arts. So there's not enough hours in a day for him to have mastered the system at that point in his life. So he was not even the clan's best fighter. That was, you know, unarguably, I believe, Wong Chung Liang, who was his mentor there. That flows into a lot of other myths about Bruce's prowess and about him having jettisoned Wing Chun because it didn't work for him. Well, he never finished his system. The rest of that stuff may or may not be true. But remember, the facts of the matter are he did not finish his system. He learned, you know, probably up to about half the system. And that's about it. And I know where this one's going. Bruce Lee took a dim view of Kali and Eskrima. He saw them, didn't like them. They were too complicated. And they didn't fit into the integration of what Jeet Kune Do was with broken rhythm and simplicity. If you'd like to look at it, we'll provide a link for it, of Bruce Lee really dressing down another certain Jeet Kune Do guy, a student of his, in the Game of Death footage that I don't think was released totally when it first thing came out in the theatrical release, but it's in the expanded edition. But Bruce is literally saying in there, to the Eskrima man, he says, when you find out your rehearsed routines can't keep up with broken rhythm, you're going to be in really deep trouble.
You know, baby, this bamboo is longer, more flexible, and very much alive. And when your flashy routine cannot keep up with the speed and elusiveness of this thing here, all I can say is that you will be in deep trouble.
He was not very fond of anything that was complicated, and that really was complicated. So again, we're not going to get into the larger, you know, offshoots of that, but that's just a myth. He didn't like it. He also didn't break his back in some hyper-formal Chinese fight over defending the honor of the Kung Fu schools there. As it was another movie, which is horrible, the Dragon Story. Horrible movie. He hurt his back doing good morning exercises. When you put weight on your back and you bend straight over and come straight back up. Again, great for the Roman muscle, your gluteus maximus, not so good for the disc in your back. Good morning exercises are what a lot of women do to try to make their butts look good for guys. You know, that's nice, we appreciate it, but it's a very bad exercise. Bruce found that out when he blew his disc out and hurt his back. And that set off a rather catastrophic string of events later. In terms of him taking cortisone and so forth, he was always in pain. So that's what hurt his back. It wasn't a fight. It wasn't a kick from behind in some kind of a kung fu tournament or whatever. And this is a rough one to say. I think he would have beaten Brad Pitt in a fight. And so, no, but he didn't lose a fight to a stuntman in Hollywood. He didn't do that. Some people in the Jeet Kune Do and the Bruce Lee Foundation got all bent out of shape that Tarantino had the audacity to show, you know, Bruce Lee losing a fight and being a real cocky, arrogant, condescending blowhard.
You're the one with the big mouth, and I would really enjoy closing it, especially in front of all my friends. But my hands are registered as lethal weapons. That means we get into a fight, I accidentally kill you, I go to jail.
Anybody accidentally kills anybody in a fight, they go to jail. It's called manslaughter.
It was a movie, and Tarantino, by the way, killed off Hitler early. I see this in certain Jeet Kune Do fields where they are not practitioners. They are like fans, hyper fanboys. And if you turn Jeet Kune Do in a fan club, it's not a martial art anymore. Or they become kind of like historians, which is fine, but there's a big difference between going to a historic battlefield, like spending all your time at Gettysburg because you love the Civil War, And then you actually being a student at West Point, or you being, you know, at Parris Island in the Marine Corps, totally different. So that's the thing. We have to have a real clear-eyed understanding of who Bruce Lee was and what he did. And so we can see the art and let us use it. Remember, but it's about us being able to defend ourselves, not, you know, just being fans. Okay. So don't forget to click the like and subscribe button. If you don't do that, something terrible is going to happen. You're going to, I don't know, the dryer is going to eat your socks. Incidentally, I remembered some videos of people getting mad at me for saying that because they're like, the words can hurt them. I'm speaking ill to them. And I read that and I think it's a joke, first of all. But second of all, how good is your self-defense going to be if you think a dude on YouTube telling you that your socks are going to get eaten by your dryer is going to cause you irreparable harm in your life? I mean, I'm just trying to help. So, but seriously, thank you for watching. Click the like and subscribe button, and hopefully this was helpful and edifying. And we're not bashing Bruce. You know, I was just talking to the guys before we shot the video that there's a bunch of people out there that will now accuse me of bashing Bruce having this video. No, it's about edifying you and making sure we don't fall prey to myths. You know, it doesn't do us any good to be believing something that's not true. So here we go with that. Catch you next time.